Hey everyone, today I'm going to make the marble shenanigans a little bit better. In these boxes is the result of everything I've learned about design during this whole long crazy process. If they work, the marble shenanigans will work. If they don't work, it might be time to give up on the whole project. So, future of the machine is literally here. Let's see what's inside. So these are the laser cut steel profiles for the escapement marble gates. And in the other bag, we have the parts for the cyber gate for the cyber base. Wow. Absolute first thing I want to check is this magnetic? And it's not. Perfect. So stainless steel is most often not magnetic, but some stainless steel for welding are. I'm not sponsored by this company, but I'm such a happy client, normal customer right now, that I have to say thanks to Taylor Steele and Boris. I uploaded my step files. I got a price quote within a minute. I redesigned this part to make it cheaper to order, and I had the parts within a week. I submitted this design in bent format, and they bent this part for me. Look at this. Yes, machine bending. No more Martin bends manually. What I want to try today is to weld one escapement gate assembly. So I'm going to pick all the parts needed for that. And I'm also going to set all the cyber gate parts aside. Here is cyber gate. Super nice parts. Here's the attachment plate we designed on a live stream. Let's see if our puzzle fit is good. Okay, so I've been thinking a lot about tolerances. What do you think about this tolerance? It clicks into place. If you look closely, you can see small little cutouts in the corners. That's the dog bone shape to count for the laser curve. And that just makes this snap fit. Next part, the intro profile. Let's see if we can also get a snap from this one. I might not be the most reliable designer, but I taught myself how to design in CAD for being able to order parts from a professional manufacturer and make them snap fit in place. I don't give up, okay? Next part, the Batman profile. So if you see, there's a little ledge here. So I designed that little ledge to know exactly where this should be. So up here and towards that stop, like so. This goes hooking under like that, and then in here. My maker hands are shaking from excitement. So here you can kind of see the assembly goes together, and I can tease the brass wheel here. Is it shiny? Oh, it's shiny. Look at that. I was planning to weld this together now, but I realized it's not smart. In the escapement gate, we have these axles, and I need to weld them on first, but I don't have the axles yet. So instead of welding this assembly, I'm going to work on the dropper arms. These are the dropper arms in the escapement gate, and I have all the parts for them, so let's start working on them. When I ordered these parts, I have to put them together, because there's a limitation in how small parts can be cut by this manufacturer. So I put this little cutaway tab here, here, and here. And first step with these parts is to remove this tab. All these parts are cut loose and ready for welding. And since this is stainless steel and very, very thin and small, I need to think a little bit how to weld this. So I'm actually going to use silicon bronze TIG brazing. So it's not technically welding. Silicon bronze TIG brazing have a lower melting temperature, which means I don't really need to melt these small little parts before this filler material melts and glues them together, kind of. So that's good. And also, my normal filler rods is for mild steel, and you shouldn't really blend stainless steel with mild steel. By the end of the process, I will weld the stainless dropper arms to mild steel's arms on the Marble Machine X, and that's the best example of where silicon bronze TIG brazing comes into play, because it can weld different alloys to each other. So my material is pretty thin, so I'm going to twist it together into a thicker size. I want to share my number one beginner tip for TIG welding, and that's working position. This might sound stupid, but to me it makes such a big difference. Step number one, I have a high good welding chair, so I'm not standing welding. Step two is support for the arm. This old Tony taught me this. So instead of having the arm in the air like this, going back and forth, I always put some support. So this height worked great. Next thing is the cable. The cable is pulling on the gun, so my hand has to hold up this whole weight. I cannot put the cable around my neck. By having the cable around my neck, there's no weight on the gun. Again, increases the precision and makes this less painful. Turn on the argon, and we're gonna start cold. With the lower melting temperature of this fill rod, I can weld colder, and the closer I am, I can also weld colder. That will point the heat exactly where we need it and not everywhere else. Less heat means less distortion, means straighter parts. So I put one tack right here on one side. Then if we turn to the other side, so there you go. I'm gonna do a third one here. Probably completely unnecessary, but the marbles will go there, so why not? I'm going to do it a little bit colder, 50. Went a little bit too fast for my taste. So here you can see the nice fillet. It goes smooth to the surface and it comes down to the other part. That looks really nice. Let's check the backside. So you see kind of same thing here. That looks actually nice. I'm gonna try to turn it around. Here's kind of the two welds I made from the backside going into each other, then from the other side. So I didn't clean the metal before. I just couldn't be bothered. And the parts are pretty clean, so it seems okay. So I'll trust this as a dropper. Now I just have to make all of them. I have all the 32 arms put together, and now I can start with one of the most important design aspects of this design, silence. So this design is designed to be silent. What I want to avoid is the metal on metal sound, this. In the beginning of the process, I didn't really care about designing for silence. I take it more seriously now, so let's get into it. What I have here on the table is silicone tubing and heat shrink. On these two arms, I'm going to have the heat shrink, and I cut a block of exactly 16 millimeters. So first I slide the shrink to this wall, then I slide my piece to the same wall, and then I can make the cut. So, and then in here I have two taps, and that's for the silicone tube. And then I made another distance, this is 9 millimeters, and it's the same idea. To hold this silicone tube, I made these two tabs to make a mechanical bond. I would never use glue or anything for this, so this I think is good design. So the silicone tube is going against a metal rail like this, and where the metal rail is meeting the tube is hollow. There's no material inside, so this has a really nice squishy dampening effect. I think the lengths are good, so now I just have to make all 32. Pretty good. So I finished these parts following the laws of thermodynamics. I looked it up here. It says first law of thermodynamic. Whenever a maker completes a task using a direct ice pick, he has to shove it into an object to make it stand up and make it look cool in the end. Okay, so the assembly of the escapement gates have begun. It's a long process and I have spent so much intimate time thinking of every millimeter, every design decision of this whole assembly. So I think I'm gonna cover this process in a little bit of a mini-series, doing several videos on how putting these escapement gates together, because they really are the key to the Marble Machine X's future. So, hope you like this. Thanks to everyone who are watching this series. Thanks to everyone who are supporting through YouTube memberships and through Patreon. And wish me luck, because if this works, the Marble Machine X will work. If they don't work, I think I'll have to admit defeat, that I can't make this machine work. So I do feel optimistic right now, because this part is proof of concept that the silicon bronze TIG brazing with the stainless is a perfect process, and also that my heat shrink at my silicon tubes seems to do a really, really good job. This is the technique that I used to put together the whole assembly. So that was tested today and I feel really, really positive and optimistic about that. So yeah, that's it for today. I'll see you in the next video. Take care.